Fishin Affliction. Hello.
It's time to wet a line. It's Fishin Affliction time for those who got it bad.
Well, Mom and Dad's grab the kids, it's time for the fishing show. Me and the big dog's gonna go catch them down at the fishing hole. Well, you better stick around, cause you don't know what you're missing. Yeah, me and the big dog's got that fishing affliction. Grab your hats, grab your baits, don't forget your poles. We're gonna fire up that old Ranger boat and head to the fishing hole. We're gonna try to catch a big one. Yeah, that's what we're wishing. Cause me and the big dog's got that fishing affliction. Yeah, me and the big dog's got that fishing affliction. Yeah, and we've got it bad.
I've got that fishing affliction.
Just like me. Here,
fishy here, fishy here, fishy here.
Another good solid
log
now. It ain't big
as
Dennis's,
though,
but it's a
few Dennis's would eat that for breakfast, I think,
to go. It's time to wet a line. It's Fishin Affliction time. Thank you for tuning in once again. It's your old pal Matthew Gillen, the voice of Fishin Affliction here at the HD Studios. On today's episode, it's the season 10 opener of Fishin Affliction. For the show, we'll call Home, Home on the Range-er. For the big dog, Rusty Russ, Dan the Man Permanent, and Ranger Boats rep, Mr. Dennis Tobin. Hey, if you haven't picked up your Fishin Affliction second anniversary gift set, you need to get to our online store, fishinaffliction.com. Check out our video archives anytime on YouTube, and our featured Team Fishin Affliction Facebook Friend of the Week is coming up at the end of the show. So sit back and relax and enjoy Home, Home on the Ranger on Fishin Affliction TV.
Well, folks, it never ceases to amaze me, the beauty that God creates. And every sunrise is the birth of a new and exciting day. And I just enjoy sharing them with you here on Fishin Affliction TV, as these are beautiful and precious moments. And I hope you enjoy watching them as much as I do sharing them with you. And speaking of beautiful, well, that's exactly what this Tom Turkey thought he was that morning there on Percy Priest, as the big dog and I were out there fishing with the Ranger rep, Mr. Dennis Tobin. Now, while this big Tom Turkey was looking for love in all the right places, the big dog was throwing that red eye and putting the very first largemouth of the day in his Ranger boat.
Not much of a fish, but a fish anyway, starting out.
Well, big dog, who are we in the boat with this morning?
Well, I'll let him introduce himself. Dennis, why don't you introduce yourself,
Dennis? Hi, I'm Dennis Tobin with Ranger Boats.
Ranger Boats?
Ranger Boats.
Good to have you in the boat this morning.
Thank you, guys.
Fishin Affliction, my friend. Thanks
good
for being here with
good
us.
Good to be here.
We're on an early, early start. We've had the turkeys out here strutting their stuff, starting out. So, anyway, we're on J. Percy Priest, alias the Rock Garden, and we're going to catch these largemouth this morning.
Should we expect a little bigger one than that, big dog, today?
I hope that's just bait.
What do you think, Dennis?
I say if we don't catch anything, we look at the turkeys, we'll be in good shape.
Yeah, I tell you what, that was beautiful this morning,
yes,
wasn't it?
Yeah, that was great to look at.
Well, folks, Dennis loves to work a top water lure, and as we all know, Strike King has released their brand new sexy dog, and that's exactly what Dennis has tied on the end of his Seaguar line. And it wasn't long before a big old largemouth couldn't stand it anymore.
Throwing the brand new sexy dog.
There
he got him too, didn't he?
Here you go, if you don't.
Is that fun right there, Dennis, or what?
That's great. One cast over the point.
There he is. Looks like a. Is that a largemouth or a smallmouth?
That's a largemouth.
Bad. There you go, big guy.
Was that fun or what, buddy?
He's excited this morning.
Now that's fun
that's
when you start
bigger.
Catching on top water right off the bat. Good job.
I can tell that wasn't Dennis's first time throwing a topwater bait.
I'd rather catch him that way than anywhere.
I think we're going to have us a fun. Yes, sir.
What you need, though?
I'm thinking Steve Wise here. Grab hold of us.
Let's hook this. Not too bad, huh?
Not too bad of a good start there.
That's good large, man.
I'll tell you what, you think there might be, might pull another one off of there, maybe, huh?
Yeah.
It's not every day we get a topwater bite.
Hey, I told you this is going to be topwater. You remember what I told you this time last year?
I do remember.
We caught 60 in one day on it. This is going to be that kind of day. So these males are going to be guarding their beds.
That's a good start, first cast across the point like that.
You're
going to
catch another one right there.
How about that?
I told you, they're going to be loaded up right there.
Now, that's a good fish right there, buddy. That's a good fish.
Looking at fighting over there, too.
Big dog, get out there, would you? Oh, that is a dandy fish, Dennis. That is a...
Dennis,
let me get the big ones out when you get in there.
Holy cow, my friend. Oh, look at that. Look at that. Oh my gosh, that's a five. That's maybe five right there, man.
Good job.
Hell yeah. There you go.
That's a solid, solid largemouth, man. Good job, big dog.
That's a bad way to start the day, for sure.
All right, now that one there, we don't let them go. We put them in the box and we save them for the end of the day. Let them go. Whatever.
I believe she just swiped at it, too. I don't believe she was really wanting it.
Boy, I tell you what, that's a healthy fish.
She didn't like that thing around her bed was what it was.
Look at that. How about that? Now, listen, you've got two casts invested to that point. You going to throw a third time?
Maybe a fourth and a fifth.
Yeah,
I'll tell you what, let me take that one and I'll put it in the box for the hero shot later. All right, man.
Yeah, big dog.
Well, folks, it looks like the Ranger rep, Dennis Tobin, knows how to catch those big largemouths. And in a moment, Dennis is going to share with us some exciting news there from Ranger Boats as we continue our fishing trip there in the wilds of Percy Priest. But speaking of in the wilds, let's go see some pictures from this week's
In the Wild.
Well, folks, whether it's daytime or nighttime, it doesn't matter for Mr. Brian Edwards because he's going fishing and he's catching fish just like this big 6-plus-pound largemouth. Great fish, Brian. And here's Mr. Jimmy Jordan with a handful of Percy Priest largemouth and smallmouth. And this is Daniel Baldwin, who caught this largemouth, which was the big fish, in his recent high school bass tournament. Congratulations, Daniel. And this is Ryan Miller with a big old white bass that he recently caught. Great fish, Ryan. And folks, like father, like son. This is Mickey Short's son with his very first crappie. How about that big old smile and that big old slab? Folks, you can send us your pictures at pics@fishandaffliction.com and be sure to visit the picture galleries at our Facebook page and also our website. And be sure to send us your pictures and maybe you'll see them right here on the big screen.
In the wild. Your pictures in the wild.
You know, I love to fish crankbaits. I'm always looking for that edge. For years, I've looked for that special crankbait, that one that has that really unique action that really catches the fish. The 1.5 and 2.5 to me are really special. It was a hard job to build it into every one to get it that searching type, erratic motion out of it, but we nailed it. You can't believe the action of these baits. The KVD 1.5 and 2.5 helped me win my third Angler of the Year title. The KVD 1.5 and 2.5, money in the bank, baby.
Smyrna Ready Mix is an established company that handles business daily with integrity and professionalism. Whether you're a general contractor, professional builder, or a do-it-yourself homeowner, SRM has your concrete solutions. With several convenient locations in the Middle Tennessee area to serve you, the only call you need to make is to SRM, ready to serve you with integrity and professionalism.
Before launching your boat this summer, it's important to inspect your boat's structural components, systems, and motor for deterioration, corrosion, and damage that may have developed over the winter.
You should also check your boat's safety equipment and ensure it's in good working condition, including life jackets that have been stored on the boat.
It may take up to an hour to perform a boat maintenance inspection, but in the long run, it can prevent unnecessary headaches and possible accidents on the water.
Thank you. Eternal Trail for those who've got it bad. Brought to you by SRM Smyrna Readiness. Serving you with professionalism and integrity.
Folks, here's the tournament trail results for Mike's Thursday night tournament there on Percy Priest, held on May 17th, 2012. In first place with 10.06 pounds, the team of Bubba Campbell and Jeremy Hurd, who also had the big largemouth that weighed 4.50 pounds. In second place with 9.89 pounds, the team of Derek Elgin and Mark Adams, who also had the big smallmouth that weighed 4.01 pounds. Congratulations, guys. And folks, congratulations to all who participated in the Wounded Warriors tournament there on Kentucky Lake this past weekend. It is absolutely a tournament where everybody is truly a winner. Our thanks to Smyrna Ready Mix for sponsoring the tournament trail. And now back to Fishin' Affliction.
Welcome back to Fishin' Affliction, and this segment of the show is brought to you by Clark Marine Sales in Franklin, Tennessee, offering the very best of Ranger, Triton, Sea Arc, Express, Sea Ray, Bayliner, Miranda Pontoon Boats, Centurion Towboats, Yamaha, and Mercury brands. Clark Marine has been serving you with excellence for over 30 years. So for all your boating needs, see Stuart and the award-winning team at Clark Marine Sales.
How about that? Now that's a good fish right there, buddy. That's a good fish.
Well, folks, welcome back to Fishin' Affliction, and right before the break, we saw the Ranger rep, Dennis Tobin, doing battle with a big old Percy Priest largemouth on that brand new sexy dog from Strike King.
Holy cow, my friend. Oh, look at that. Look at that. Oh, my gosh. That's a five. That's maybe five right there, man.
Good job. That's a solid, solid large mount, man. Good job, big dog.
That is a bad way to start the day.
Boy, I tell you what, that's a healthy fish.
He
right
didn't
there.
Like that thing around her bed, was what it was.
Look at that. How about that? Now, listen, you've got two casts invested to that
two
point.
Casts.
You going to throw a third time?
Maybe a fourth and a fifth.
Yeah,
I'll tell you what, let me take that one and I'll put it in the box for the hero shot later. All right, man.
Yeah, big dog.
Well, folks, as I'm putting Dennis's big old largemouth in those Ranger live wells, let's visit with Dennis so he can tell us some of the exciting things that are going on there at Ranger Boats. Still building legends one at a time.
Exciting things going on at Ranger Boats.
Yes, sir. This is our 45th anniversary this year. We're going to be celebrating here in July, and 45 years of building the best boat in the market. It's going to be exciting times for us. Got a lot of new product we're going to introduce up there. Forrest's birthdays are going to also be celebrated that time, so it's going to be a really, really exciting time up at the... There's a fish there.
I hate the fish. And we'll be back with more information on Ranger Boats.
Look, you have to have your...
Right on the bank. It's lean.
There you go. Keep pulling hard in. Man.
We got a boxer or no? What do you think?
It's man. No. Male.
You sure bit it, though.
What's that? Pretty fish, aren't they?
Yes, sir. They are pretty and green this morning, for sure.
Tell me a little bit about the 100 series.
Yeah, we got a new series of Z100 series we come out with, and it's a 117, a 118, a 119, which is our 17.5-footer to 19.5-footer. Been really, really exciting for us. It's a little bit more affordable boat. Comes in the mid-20s to the mid-40s, and it just gives a guy a chance to get into the Ranger family a lot sooner than he does on a Comanche series, something like that. It's really exciting. Got a lot of opportunity for young men to go out and spend $25,000, $26,000 and get in a Ranger with a nice center rod box. You can hold 8-foot rods. It's just really, really an awesome tournament boat.
That's exciting, isn't it?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. That's it sure great. Is.
Well, speaking of exciting, this topwater bite, is it on this morning?
It's just barely biting. I tell you, man, it's tough. It's tough. Got a 5-pounder in the box already. And
we've been fishing all 20 minutes and had 6 bites.
It's just been tough. We can hardly film because we're catching so many, but it's.
But yeah, you know,
I think
you guys,
we're up for the challenge.
You guys are having a rough time up here, ain't you?
Well, folks, as we all know, times are tough. Money is extremely hard to come by for everybody. And it's good to see a company like Ranger ranger, coming up with some type of option and solution for those who have that fishing affliction just like we do. And folks, if you want to see some of these beautiful boats that Dennis just told you about, head on down to Clark Marine and see Stuart and that award-winning team down there, and they'll take care of you. A whole lot better than the big dog who wouldn't even give his co-host a bait to fish with. So all I could do is sit in the back of the boat and film and make fun of the fish that the big dog caught.
Dennis's would eat that for breakfast, I think, big dog.
Yeah. Spots on that tail.
I don't know if it's a keeper or not. He looked bigger. He got smaller, man. You know, I hate it when they shrink on the way in.
He hit big.
Look. See, it's stress marks. I call those bedding stress marks. He's stressed out. Let's let him go.
Hey, big dog, that was a big one.
Oh, I'm going to show you big
one. That was massive.
All right, let me tell you one thing we're not doing. All right, somebody needs a floating worm.
Yeah, I need it.
Like a ocho.
Yeah.
And when that happens, you throw right in behind him and let it lay there.
I'll do it.
That fish won't be able to stand that.
I will put one on.
You'll take an ocho.
I'm sure you guys are going to fish really extra slow today.
God almighty, how did I miss that one? See, here's what's happening, and I've seen them do it. They'll hit that bait. They don't even open their mouth. They'll hit it like this.
Hit it?
Yeah. They'll hit it like they nose it, like that.
Just pushing it out of the way.
Yeah. They don't want to eat it. They just don't want it there. Or they'll take, I've seen them take their tails and actually turn around and smack the bait.
That explains why that big one hit. If she had it underneath her mouth, she probably pushed it and just hooked it.
Well, folks, you're seeing one of the main reasons I enjoy the fish with the big dog so much. He has so much knowledge and experience to share, and he's not afraid to share it with you. Thanks for the fishing lesson, big dog. And in a moment, folks, we'll be back with Mr. Dennis Tobin, the big dog, and myself there on Percy Priest, home on the Ranger. But right now, it's time to hear from the voice of Fishing Affliction, Mr. Matthew Gillen, as he tells us about the weekly Team Fishing Affliction special from Clark Marine.
All right, gang, here's a 2007 Skeeter. This is a ZX200 dual console model with a Yamaha 200 HPDI engine, a Lowrance 332C in the console, and a Lowrance X135 on the bow. Has a mid-coat of Maxim Pro 80, this is one well-kept boat. Call now for special pricing or cruise on in and see Stuart and the award-winning team at Clark Marine Sales, Paytonsville Road, exit 61 off I-65, Franklin, Tennessee. And now let's head upstairs to the kitchen, see what Miss Vic's got cooking for us this week.
In the Skillet with Chef Vicki Porter is brought to you by Kleepy.com, turning your precious memories into video treasures.
Welcome to In the Skillet. I'm Vicki Porter, and today I'm going to show you a quick and easy side dish that will go great with all those crappie recipes I've been showing you lately. It's for garlic angel hair pasta. And now for the ingredients. You will need angel hair pasta, garlic cloves, olive oil, Parmesan cheese, and garlic salt. While your water is coming to a boil for your pasta, prep your garlic cloves by removing the skins, because we're actually going to boil our garlic in with our pasta. Once your water comes to a boil, let's add our pasta and also add our garlic cloves, and cook these according to the directions on your package. After you've cooked and drained your pasta, add your olive oil. Now add a little bit of garlic salt. Next, add your Parmesan cheese and toss this and get it coated really evenly. After this is finished cooking, it's time to sit down and enjoy this garlic angel hair pasta. You can find this recipe at intheskillet.com, and be sure and click on the YouTube icon to see this recipe as well as all of my other In the Skillets. And folks, be sure and send us your recipes. You can leave them on our Facebook pages or email them to me. And you might see your recipe here in the Skillet on Fishin' Affliction TV. I'm Vicki Porter. Tune in next week to see what's cooking in the Skillet.
A few months ago, I watched my good friend Rick McFerrin catch almost an 11-pound largemouth. I actually taped him catching that fish. We got it in the boat. We took some measurements of that fish. He let it go, and he's going to get a replica made of it. That way that fish can live, and he can have a commemoration of the day. But I also offered to get him a TARP, a Tennessee Angler Recognition Program certificate. You can also commemorate your catch through these certificates, and you can get them by going to tnwildlife.org, getting the information, and then applying for a certificate. I think they're $5, but you have to meet certain criteria. For instance, your largemouth bass has to be at least 22 inches long. A brook trout, if you're into brookies, have to be 10 inches. A blue catfish, 34 inches. A black crappie, 14 inches. A smallmouth bass has to be 20 inches. A sauger has to be 20 inches. So these are really nice fish, but you can commemorate your catch by getting this certificate. And a lot of people these days are going after certificates for each fish that I've named and a whole lot more. Go out to tnwildlife.org, learn more about the TARP program, and get you a whole bunch of certificates on a roll along with a couple of replicas. See you next time right here on Fishin' Affliction.
Well, folks, on today's Fishin' Affliction product spotlight, it's about those rugged electronic mounts from Ram Mounts. And instead of talking about them, I wanted to show you the Ram Mounts in action. And if a picture speaks a thousand words, then check out this video, folks. As you can see, we trust these Ram Mounts to hold down our very valuable Lowrance electronics. And as we're bouncing across those rough waters on Old Hickory Lake, we are confident that those rugged electronic mounts from Ram Mounts are going to do what they're designed to do, secure those valuable depth finders and anything else that they're holding. Head on over to rammounts.com to see the great selection of those rugged electronic mounts from Ram Mounts and pick you up a few to hold your valuable electronics. And now, folks, back to Fishin' Affliction. Welcome back to Fishin' Affliction, and this segment of the show is brought to you by U.S. Reel. When performance means everything. Aris Rods, don't follow, lead. Cigar Line, always the best. Mustad Ultra Point Hooks, stays sharper longer. Onyx Life Jackets, keeping you there. Fraybill, trusted gear since 1938. Blakemore's Real Magic, the name says it all. Deca Gel Batteries, Stay in Charge Battery Charging Systems, Rugged Electronic Mounts provided by Ram Mounts, Lowrance Electronics by BBGMarine.com, and Tournament Wear. Look great, feel great, do great.
Oh, that spotted bass?
Like, no, he's mad.
I'm going to tell you, you know they're bad to the bone when they hit something as long as they are.
Yeah. Hey, what the...
He had some weight on it, he would be a mean little dude.
Get him, big dog.
Come on, buddy.
I tell you what, they like that guy.
This one's got a weird mouth, too. This one, the first one had a funny mouth at the top. This one's got a funny mouth at the bottom, but he's got a real wild little tail. And what I'm catching here are males. And they're up making their beds and they're gorging. And so I'm taking the caffeine shad and I'm working it across the top of the beds. And they're not visible beds, I can't really see them. But you can absolutely have a blast throwing this thing. And Dennis is using the top water and Dan's throwing a spinnerbait. And it's just a matter of getting it in on top of the beds, you know, and getting it to a place where they don't like it. And that's what'll trigger the bite.
Spinnerbait fish,
not the first time he's eaten today.
How about that, huh? The trailer hook coming into play. This fish was hooked real good. Wouldn't have to do a little surgery, but that's a nice fish, isn't it?
Yeah, it caught them on the trailer hook, didn't you?
Yep.
A lot of these fish have been caught before on J. Percy Priest, hadn't they?
Yeah, they're starting to know us by name, aren't they? Especially you. All right, well, let me do what I need to do so I can put this beautiful fish back in the water.
All right, buddy.
Well, folks, everybody in the Ranger boat has now caught a fish. And as you can see, we started catching those fish early in the morning before the sun was up. But now that sun is up and things are starting to warm up, and as this beautiful mallard duck is basking in those warm rays of the sun, let's see what the big dog's got to say about these changing conditions.
What's happening here with the sun?
We've got a high bluebird. We got a high pressure system. So it's always going to affect the bite. So we had low light this morning. And so the fish will still hit a topwater when they're guarding, but it's going to be a little bit different deal. We may have to get the bait a little bit deeper and get it as close to the bed as possible.
And right now you're throwing a caffeine shad.
Yeah. Yep, caffeine shad. And I don't know if you've ever thrown this bait, but I'm gonna hold it up for the camera. If you've ever thrown a floating worm, this thing has a kind of a floating worm tail, so that's what I really like about the bait, because it falls like a floating worm. And a floating worm is an absolutely great bedding bait, whatever.
Well, folks, sometimes the big dog gets tongue-tied, especially when he's fishing, but he sure knows what he's talking about.
That's a nice fish.
Buddy, they are eating this caffeine shad. There he is. It's a chunk. Another male.
He is healthy.
And I'm going to tell you guys, we may catch, and you all think I'm crazy, and people talk about Percy Priest getting the amount of pressure it gets and all that, and I'm going to have to get a set of pliers. Thanks, Dan. Appreciate it. Anyway, but we may catch... You're going to think I'm crazy. We may catch 60 bass today. You wait and see. But there are going to be a lot of them that are not big, giant, you know, big, giant fish. They're going to be, you know, males like this one. But they're up here making the beds, or they've already laid out and they're guarding the beds. And that's what their job is now. So it's easy to get a reaction bite out of them, especially if you're throwing a caffeine shad.
Folks, I hope you're enjoying this episode of Fishin' Affliction TV as we're out there on Percy Priest with the Ranger Rep, Mr. Dennis Tobin. And next week, folks, we're going to see the conclusion of this trip. And folks, the Fishin' Affliction family would like to send its prayers and condolences to the family of Mr. Poppy Blair, a very well-respected and well-known angler here in Middle Tennessee. And we want to let them know that our prayers and the prayers of so many others are with them during this time. And folks, make plans to fish in the June 3rd Poppy Blair Memorial Tournament. Now, this tournament is designed to help offset all the medical costs that have been incurred by the family during this time. And the Poppy Blair Memorial Tournament will be on June 3rd, starting at 5:30 a.m. at Fate Sanders Marine. It'll run to 1:30 p.m. The entry fee is $50 per boat with a $10 optional big fish pot. There will also be several donated items that will be raffled off on the day of the tournament, and all proceeds from the raffle will go directly to Mrs. Blair. For more information, please contact Mike or Nina Bowling at those following numbers and make plans to attend and help out the family of Poppy Blair by fishing in the Poppy Blair Memorial Tournament there on Percy Priest on June 3rd. Thank you all again for tuning in to this week's episode of Fishin' Affliction TV. And tune in to next week's episode and you'll see.
All right, here's four of the keepers we caught today.
This week's Team Fishin' Affliction featured Facebook friend is Larry Binion. And thanks for being our Facebook friend. For your chance to join in the fun and become an official Team Fishin' Affliction featured Facebook friend, simply like us on Facebook. And be sure to write a comment on our wall. As always, a big thank you to all of our national and local sponsors for providing us with the most advanced technology and highest quality products and services. Be sure to visit each of our partners online through the sponsor links page on our official website at fishinaffliction.com. And this is your old pal Matthew Gillen, the voice of Fishin' Affliction TV, hoping that you'll tune in next week, because there's no doubt that Dan and the Big Dog got it bad. They've got Fishin' Affliction for those who got it bad.
People don't know, but these things will talk to you. Listen.
I love Fishin' Affliction. Yes, I do.
And he's saying,
don't throw them Strike King baits around me no more.